And it's time for our real estate report. If you are thinking of moving this summer, why now is the time to put your house on the market. Our real estate expert, Nick Marcoux, with me in studio. Always nice to see you, Nick.
Nice to see you too. Good morning.
So why is now the time to do it?
Well, we're approaching the new year. In Quebec, you know, we have July 1st as a national moving day, I guess. Not only it's Canada Day, but it's moving day as well. So we tend to have a lot of action at one period of the year here, as opposed to other places where it's not really, doesn't really work the same way. So a lot of people's leases end July 1st usually. So a lot of first-time home buyers are on the market now, especially the really serious ones like to get a head start on visiting homes and possibly finding something. So a lot of people are gearing up now for July. So
So get the ball rolling now is what, you're saying. So how does it work, though? Because you mentioned July 1st. So what if someone wants to buy my house, but they say, I don't know, I don't need it, though, until June or July? How does that work?
Well, that's another important reason why to use a real estate broker, and especially to make sure that things get done the right way. Yeah. Because the last thing you want to end up in a situation where, yeah, I sold my home for July. I bought something else. Next thing you know, I can't find the people anymore. They're not buying my house. So it creates this kind of snowball effect that you really want to avoid. So usually the way it works is that once you know, you have an offer, the person does the inspection on the home, they get their financing. You can either set a notary date for later on, let's say end of June, or you could possibly do something whereas the seller will come and make the transaction earlier on and pay you a rent up until the time where you move in.
So, basically, you got to get everything down on paper.
Exactly.
That's important. Exactly. Okay, what if I'm a first-time home buyer? I want to find something, hopefully move in the summer. What, you know, it's intimidating. It's stressful. What is the first steps I need to take? We just saw, you know, about getting pre-approved.
Yeah. The first step is, like you just said, definitely to get pre-approved. As a first-time buyer, it's a very important thing for you to do because it shows a lot of seriousness when you're out shopping. It'll be a better tool for you to negotiate. When you show a pre-approval to the seller, they might pick you over someone else who's trying to compete for the same home.
It's also nice to know how much you can afford, right, Nick? You've got to know that.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
Especially with the non-stop changes in the mortgage rules lately, it's always good to get up to date with the interest rates and whatnot. So
and mortgage rules, you mean like how much you have to put down, like down payment?
The down payment also changed. Well, the way they qualify you has changed. The interest rate has also changed lately. So a lot of the times when you get pre-approved, they'll lock you into a rate, let's say, for a certain period of time. But it's always good to go back and get updated on what your budget is, definitely.
So we talked about, you know, the other way around. If someone buys your home and only wants to move in July, what if you purchase a home but haven't sold your home yet? I mean, the timing of everything, it can be confusing. So, so what if you want to move only later on? Like, what should you do exactly?
Well, it's always funny because you never know when your house is going to sell, right?
Yeah, that's
So if you put your house on the market and you want to buy something else, like, what if somebody comes and offers you the full asking price and they want your house in 30 days? So you have to have kind of a plan. That's where you should be a little nice to your parents.
I was just about to say.
Close to the time where you're putting your house on the market. So
Yeah. Okay, so basically, if that offer comes, though, don't pass it up.
Don't pass it up, but there should be a plan in the event that something like that does happen.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much, Nick. Good advice.
Thank you.